Spots going to throw to Sharks, Jet, and Deficio for a look into game number one.
Thank you very much, Trevor. Well, there we go. SKT, very dominant win to say in game one. And those picks and bends in a game one of a series, incredibly important. And Fnatic deciding to go for the things that they are most comfortable on.
Yeah, let's talk about that a little bit, because if we look at SK Telecom as a team, there are so many champions you can say that you are playing with fire if you give it to them. Too many, in fact, to ever ban out. Undefeated Faker on LeBlanc. Rek'Sai, undefeated in this tournament for Bengi. Marin on Maokai, one defeat. Bangs, Kalista, undefeated. You can't actually target all those things. So I actually did like Fnatic's picks for the most part, because they were going for things that they knew they could snowball with in an ideal case. Steelback on something that can assist that with his ultimate as well, since they knew he was going to lose laning phase. I don't think there's much they could have improved with that pick phase for Fnatic.
No, the only problem for me was with the LeBlanc pick for Febiven. In order for that to be useful, he had to play a near-perfect game, and he didn't. I mean, we see the team talking here. Febiven, he's a young guy as well. I mean, he's here playing against Faker, playing against SKT. There's probably a lot of nerves for him, but he needs to get into this game, because his LeBlanc performance was not good enough. So if you take that away from SKT and you know, okay, there's going to be some sort of counter pick, not a counter in Ezreal, but a safe pick then for Faker against it, you have to be able to make plays somewhere. If you look just at some of the team fights, Febiven was a non-factor in them, and that meant they could never really dive the backline and always secure a kill on Faker or on Bang, which is what they had to do against that comp.
Yeah, let's actually take a look at one of the team fights where that is very obvious and get that replay up on the screen, where you look that he doesn't really go in, and also just Fnatic in general, they have to give up one at the end of this fight, but they decide to keep going.
Yeah, so just the setup here, Fnatic is doing a good job at starting the fight. When you run like Hecarim top as your main engage force, like they're running here, it's very important that every engage Huni pulls off works for them. So if you just roll the clip, they catch out Wolf, this Rainover waiting to bush, him and Huni together has been so great all tournament long, and Fnatic has a good start. But now if you look at your minimap, you can see how Faker on Ezreal and Febiven on LeBlanc is running fairly late to the fight. And now, what's very important after these two kills, when it's the two AD carries alike, we see Bang on your screen, you see Ezreal coming from mid lane, is that Fnatic coordinates the jump on one of the AD carries. So all five members, if possible, pile onto one AD carry and kill him in order to win the fight. So now, we can see Febiven at the Raptor camp. If you just roll the clip, he's going to distortion over the wall, and then he's going to ulti onto Faker, and he's going to jump all the way back to the Raptor camp. So he's really far away at the moment. He's not with the rest of his team. And the coordination for Fnatic is now really hard to pull off, and they cannot get onto the AD carries at the same time. Faker even stays alive here, and SKT turns around the fight.
Yeah, and overall, Deficio, it definitely felt like there was a sense of desperation from Fnatic in this game. Like, for instance, they weren't necessarily behind in the game, but we saw tons of teleports for Huni really trying to force things extremely hard. I think even mentally, because of the defeat they suffered yesterday against SKT when they had that huge lead and couldn't close, they're trying even harder to just build up a bigger lead.
Yeah.
And that is allowing SKT to just kind of sit back and play their game, counterplay their team fights really well, and just play the kite game that the double AD comp was designed to do there.
Yeah, as you mentioned, that is the weakness that we've seen in Fnatic, that they do want to go in when it's not the ideal time for them, when SKT really hit their power spike and was able to drive it home. And as you said, SKT, they could kind of pick a comp. They have so many options going into the rest of these series now, knowing what they picked now and what they did.
And here's the thing about best of five series. A lot of times SK Telecom will kind of start with their B plan at the start of a series to see how you adjust. If we look at their double AD composition with Ezreal mid, that's something they haven't played in months. It's not their best team composition, and they were able to win with that actually fairly easily. I don't think they're going to play that composition again. Because they should have plenty of other things in their repertoire.
I'm sure they have a lot of things, but Fnatic has also shown some new picks in this tournament. The casters were talking about Azir for Faker event, potentially it's been banned a few times, yeah. But clearly it's been a practice pick. Maybe he can pull it up if he wants to go away from these all-in assassins, which has not always worked for him, his Zed pick as well. Febiven is such a fantastic player. If he steps up his game, I think Fnatic has a chance of taking a game off SK Telecom, as long as they don't make any of these crucial mistakes in the early game that can set them behind.
And it will be crucial for them to stay calm now, and we're also going to take a quick break while the teams regroup, but we'll be right back for game two between SKT and Fnatic. The midseason invitational continues right after this.
Yesterday, they were able to come back from a 10k deficit. Even if we are winning really hard the game, we have to continue trying as hard as possible in every minute of the game.
He gets a double barrel body slam. Marin on the back line as it's a 3v4. Faker continuing to spam out Mystic Shot after Mystic Shot. Marin trying to shred them down. Rainover's in retreat. Hooney's low. That's a knock up on Faker, and Yellowstar knocks him into the waiting hands of Febavin. Hooney's now going to be the next victim, but the Boomerang Blade kills the man that started it all. Wolf is down. That's a four-man knock up, and Febavin eats a death sentence. Wolf has removed one of the damage dealers. The assassin is forced to retreat. Steelback trying to get through. SK Telecom will knock the first nail into Fnatic's coffin.